And welcome back to another Speedieclark production during COVID-19. So filmmaking has been a bit difficult because it's all been about Zwift and training and high intensity, following all the government guidelines. But today we have an interesting film today. So we are out in the Pine Forest. Absolutely stunning forest, and just to show you that I'm within the government guidelines, okay? Basically, this is within 18 minutes of my house. To be honest, only probably about 9 or 10 minutes on the road bike. But today we are reviewing the 2020 Giant Trance 29er. Alloy version with Fox Rhythmic 34 front suspension, Hope wheels. It's an absolute gem of the bike. SRAM group set, one by. Now these are my original Shimano XT pedals, which I've used for the last 5 years, and they've been super reliable. Absolutely stunning bike. Love the colour scheme. Apologies for the cube water bottle. It was all that I had that would fit in with this frame. You have to use a side pull bottle mount. And the bottles that I have are actually a bit too big to go into here. I don't want to cause damage to the frame. GoPro mount. I've just put my Wahoo on. Obviously today there is no power. Now today's training is actually just 45 minutes zone one. Super easy because tomorrow I have a time trial, and it's not a time trial outside, it's a time trial indoors, just to clarify that. On Zwift, it's a program set up for myself to follow to test my 1 hour power. So yesterday was a rest day, today is a super easy spinning day, so I'm going to take that opportunity to use the local forest down the road from my house, where they have been doing a lot of tree felling, as you can see, and there's some nice paths being carved into this forest that weren't originally there. So I'm just going to ride round. I've never actually been in here before, even though it's just down the road from my house, so it's going to be interesting to see what the trails are like, have some fun checking out the Giant Trance 29er. And I'll feedback and give a review on that. Now, as you know, I actually own a 27.5 with 140mm travel front and back. It's not as extreme as the Giant Rain, which is like an enduro slash downhill type bike. Probably more of an enduro bike, to be honest. My Trance 27.5 is like, it goes downhill pretty well. It is kind of like enduro, but it's got the Fox 32 suspension, so a bit lighter than an enduro bike, and it kind of does everything pretty well. But I want to check out the 29er. Now the 29er, as I said, has got the Fox 34 rhythmic front and rear suspension. Now it only has 120mm of travel front and rear, but because it's a 29er, the size of the 29 inch wheels more than make up for that difference. I have been on this trail now, although it looks relatively not too bad here, the climb to get up to here, because I have climbed up to here over the last 6 minutes, was very, very rocky from the bulldozers, etc., that have been up here. So the bike's climbed super well, but it's quite bizarre because I actually haven't ridden a mountain bike since the Strathpuffer 24-hour mountain bike race, and the position on the bike compared to road bike, time trial bike, aero bike is obviously entirely different. And I feel a bit, I'm going to say it, uncomfortable to begin with. You know, I didn't feel like the power transfer was very good. Now, yes, it's a mountain bike, but you can still be efficient and good power transfer on a mountain bike. Felt like my seat was a bit too far forward. I felt like the reach wasn't quite long enough. But this is the right size of bike for me. It's been dialed in. It's exactly the same proportion as my 27.5. It's just the fact that I haven't you know, ridden a mountain bike for a period of time. So anyway, enough of the waffle, we're going to crack on with the review and see how this baby performs. Super excited. Now, I have chosen the alloy version. For me, carbon, I'm a road rider, I do make mistakes when I'm off-road, so I wouldn't want to risk damaging a carbon bike, because in my opinion, carbon bikes are super awesome, super strong in terms of rigidity, but if you were to crash and hit a big rock, in my opinion, you're smashing the frame. So I have chosen the alloy version. In terms of full suspension, yeah, there's a little bit of difference in weight, but if I'm going to be brutally honest for what I'm doing, am I going to really notice it that much? Probably not. Okay, so on with the film, let's ride this bad boy.
About anything, right? It's obviously 20 feet depending on where you can and cannot ride.
So let's go, we're counting in the mix. Let's go, go, go. Check this classic out, it's round and round. We'll be right back. Okay, so that is ours now on the way home. I'm very, very lucky to live where I live. So, giant Trance 29er, Fox 34 rhythmic suspension. What do I think of it? I think it's bloody amazing. Absolutely fantastic. Climbs well, descends well. The 120mm of travel, more than enough. The 29-inch wheels roll really, really well. The Hope hubs are absolutely sublime. Criticisms? It's a little bit heavier than my 27.5, but I would say it climbs faster, so not really an issue. The SRAM won by. Oh, need to be careful what I say, but I'm going to be honest. Not sponsored in any way by Groupset, but I'm a Shimano person. I've had a few ghost shifts in the SRAM, skipping gears. I've already had to make two cable adjustments while on the ride. Now, my giant Trance with Shimano, from initial setup to cassette and chain changes, you know, just through natural wear and tear, I've never really needed to make any adjustments. It's been faultless, whereas the SRAM, I'll be honest, I don't think the SRAM's as good as Shimano. So my advice is, if you have the option, take it in Shimano, if you can get it in Shimano, which you can. Or if you see a good deal in SRAM, eventually upgrade, because I mean the SRAM's okay, but I prefer Shimano. So in a nutshell, should you consider this bike? Should you think about the bike? You know, should you just go right ahead and buy the bike, or should you avoid the bike? In my opinion, if you're after a good full suspension bike that can climb, descend and is fast, you should just go right ahead and buy the bike. So, job done. Giant Trance 29er, super awesome. Thumbs up from Speedieclark and Team Blanco. So, catch you later. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe. See you on the next one. Bye-bye.